Softail range. Changes we've made, and then some of the changes to the engine which are vital to it. We're also just to plan, if you like, we're running a test ride weekend this weekend from Friday, Saturday and Sunday. There's quite a lot booked already, but there are quite a few left, so if you speak to any number of the sales, any member of the sales team, they'll get you booked in, so don't miss out on that. These bikes are, they look fantastic, but they are all about the riding, there's no doubt about it. So how did it come about? Harley-Davidson Motor Company started off this project by going out to 3,000 different people in 5 different countries and asked them what they wanted in a new Harley-Davidson motorcycle. We got a lot of answers you'd expect: improved performance, improved styling, better braking, better handling, lighter weight, but still, most importantly, holding on to everything that you love about a Harley: the sound, the feel, the character. So in doing that, they're setting themselves a big task in changing, developing the bike significantly, but making sure that they held on to the essence of the bike, what every single model has going for it, and pull that through to the new model. Now again, it's all about the riding, but I've been lucky enough last week or so to go down to Oxford, test ride the bike, and that is exactly what they've managed to do. Don't ask me how. The bikes have dynamically have come on a long way, but they still have the essence of its predecessor. So let me tell you a little bit about some of the bones underneath of what's been changed. I can turn this bike round. I'm going to tell you a bit about the chassis, because that's part of the biggest changes to the bike. So some previous models that were Dyna-platformed, such as the Fat Bob, that you'll see to my far left-hand side, now all run like that on the Softail platform. The chassis is hugely improved. It's about 34% stiffer than the previous chassis, the previous Softail chassis. It's significantly lighter. The weight reduction is about, on average, 17 kilos. Correct? Yeah. 17 bags of sugar of a weight reduction, so a big changes there. You can even feel it when you take the bike off the stand. You see the stands are now shorter, so there's less effort for the stand, or less workload for the stand. You'll feel it just kicking off, which you'll get a chance to do in just a short while. Some of the important things about the frame. The reason it's stiffer and performs so much better is that the laws of physics and motorcycle design tell us that if you draw a straight line, or can draw a straight line from the back of the wheel spindle all the way up through this, the new massively improved rear shock, right to the headstock at the top of the headstock, that gives you the maximum performance effect, i.e. you'll get the best feel for the road, the best feedback, and the bike will feel like it handles properly. It also makes it, that design is a lot more rigid. Sean will mention that later on when he comes to talk about the engine. So that's a bit about that part of the chassis, and I think I'm going to hand you over to Ola now to tell you even more about some other bits and bobs.
Hello. One races, I think, when we went down to test drive down in England, was everyone was mentioning the lean angle significantly improved. For those of you who are used to maybe a Softail Slim or a Heritage, you'll understand the characteristic of the bike when you're turning a corner, hitting the footboard. You're not going to have that problem with any of the 2018 bikes. The lean angle is significantly improved, so you'll be flying around those corners like an albatross. Really, really good.
I purposely tried to get the board to scrape on a Heritage when I was out on a proper country road, round a 90-degree right-hander, and I couldn't. Now, I've got no doubt that there's a hill. Oh, most of you guys can ride better than I can, but trust me, it's a huge difference. It's a big, big difference. Sorry.
Kirk mentioned it's up to 17 kilograms lighter on the bikes. What they've also done is lowered the centre of gravity, so you really do feel when you're moving it off the stand, it is a fast improvement, and going at slower speeds as well, it's just far easier to handle. The other probably notable things are when you come in, when we came in, you'll see that the new LED lights, there's three different LED lights across the range. Far better riding at night, far clearer, and I think you look pretty cool as well. And probably big notable improvement is the USB ports as well. Each bike has a USB port, so you can quite easily plug your phone in and charge it up, or your sat nav, or anything that you want really. So I'll pass you over to Sean.
Can I just say, Ola is our newest member of the sales team, and a lot of you haven't met her so far, so she's fitted in brilliantly. She's been here for a few months so far, so can we just have a big round of applause for Ola? Thank you.
Okay, so I'll cover the engine and try and fill in any areas that maybe we missed off in the Kirk's lovely introduction there. The engine, the Softail range now, although looking at the bikes, most of you look at all these bikes and you all look pretty much what you need. Ian, there you go, that's better. They're familiar, you know them. The Heritage, the Fat Boy, the Street Bob, and the Fat Bob. They're all familiar to you. They're wholly new bikes. The only things you'll see these bikes now that you've seen before are the mirrors and the brakes. Okay? The mirrors and the brakes are the same. The bike after that is brand new. This is not the same bike. These have been developed over a long period of time and spent a lot of money on it. Part of the changes, obviously, is the new Milwaukee engine. We've got three engines. We've got the 107 that anybody in the touring range has seen for a while now, the 114 and the 117 on the CVOs. And anyone that's interested in brake horsepower, most of us guys don't really bother about that because we're about torque. But the 107 engine, for those who want to know, 92 brake horsepower. The 114, you got 101 brake, and the 117 is 105 brake, and they can be tuned up to about 120 brake. So there's plenty of grunt there when you want it. And what they've done with the engine, it's the same weight engine with more performance. So your power to weight ratio has gone up dramatically. So the same engine's there, it weighs about the same, but the frame and various other things, they've brought the weight down to on average about 17 kilograms less. So you have better acceleration across the range from bike to bike. You'll see that go up. And compare it with a 103, you're about 10% better performance on a 107 from a 103. And the difference between say the 107 and the 114 is about 80% difference. So you've got plenty of grunt there. You'll feel that when you get out on the road to these bikes. These bikes have to be ridden to really see the bit of the changes. The stunning looking bikes and nice aesthetic changes. The 240 back end and the flat bob is glorious. A stunning looking bike, a real head turner. Nice beefy front end. All the signature headlights in there. You see that bike behind you, passing you, coming towards you. You'll know it's a Harley just by the headlight alone. But the performance of this bike, it's now what oil cooled. You've got an oil cooler in the front of the bike, so you may see at the front end of there. The oil tank that used to sit just below the seat there, that's now a sump. So they've moved the weight down, they've moved the battery down, the center of gravity's down. So anybody like Kirk and Gary and the likes of the sort of inside leg, these tall guys, when you're taking the bike off the stand, you'll find it a lot easier. Everybody will find it easier, but anyone that's struggling a bit with the heavier bikes, you'll find that one, the bike's lighter, but because the stand's shorter, it's a bit more upright, and the centre of gravity's lower, getting it off the stand's going to be a lot easier. And then get out and ride it. the bike, we were taken aback by how much of a difference that they're having. The breakout, by the way, we've not got one on the demo plate at the moment. I'm still working on cut to try and get one. The breakout has a massive
it's the biggest change, without a doubt.
Surprise us all. We all want to ride the Fat Bob. The Fat Bob is glorious. It's stunning. It's a cracking looking bike, nice aggressive looking bike. That new 107 and the 114 engine, you'll love it. You'll want to ride it. The test rides start tomorrow through to Sunday, and there's still a good number of slots for Saturday and Sunday, so if you want to ride it, get in quick. We'll take the bookings down, we'll put your name down. Our slots initially, obviously the bikes will still be there sort of later on, but I'd get in quick. In terms of sales so far, we've seen a massive upturn in bike sales because of these new bikes. The minute that the order option was there, the bikes are selling. Sold two Heritages this week. The Heritage Softail, Cruck says that the lean angle is vastly improved, the Softail Slim is vastly improved. I rode the Softail Slim down in Barmory, and I was on a Slim, following a Slim. What I didn't realise, the Slim in front of me was a 103, and I approached the first roundabout, and all I could hear was that, I don't know if anyone owns a Slim here, but first roundabout, the telltale, as you go round the roundabout, I'm thinking, God, I thought that was supposed to be better. What I didn't realise was I was on the new one, he was on the bad one. When I got to that roundabout, I really threw it in and nothing. So
quite observant for a Harley salesman
there. I was riding and enjoying the moment. So, any other questions? Have we got any questions?
A couple of bits I missed. Well, one bit I missed was, I suppose a question might be, how do you have one chassis to make all these different, eight different models? The chassis comes in three different forms, essentially the same middle part, if you like, but the front end is either raked out or raked in, depending on what model the bike is. Obviously raked in for tighter turning, raked out to feel more like how a breakout would have felt and how it still feels now, but 10 times better. And the same with the back, swing arm adjustment, the shock absorber length and such like different in the back to make the bike feel different. That's one of the ways that they managed to make a Heritage still feel like a Heritage and a Fat Bob still feel like Fat Bob. So just in case that was a question that you might have had. And just also, they've been talking about weight and such like. The Street Bob especially is easy to pick up if you drop it. Sure, Ola will tell you that. But she didn't see that albatross this morning, unfortunately for her. So, yeah, that was it. No, I'm only kidding. So, yeah, for me, that's. I hope that gives you enough information on the bike. Does anybody have any questions?
What's the turning screw for the suspension, what's
your
range on that, and what's the benefits with it?
That's a very good question, it's something we missed as well. Okay, so they all have adjustable rear shocks. A couple of the models that's accessed here, the variation is actually that big a number, I'll be honest, I can't remember, it's enormous, it's like way more than you'd imagine you'd ever need. So you can adjust this and, help me Sean, what's the other, from the breakout, from this knob here. The other ones are adjusted under the seat, but all very easy to adjust. Now, see, if you ask anybody that's owned the Softail up to now, you ask 100 people, you'd be lucky if two of them will say they've adjusted the shocks, or they've even asked us to adjust the shocks. Now, if you're going to go two up on your own, two up full of luggage, whatever you're going to do, you can adjust it before you leave home, and readjust it when you get back.
So you don't need to mess with back tyre pressures and all that?
No. Way, way easier. You could still consider for better performance at the back tyre and adjusting that up, but obviously the adjustment in the shop is going to do most of the job, and it's much more accessible.
Alright, thanks.
Anybody else?
What's the price range percentage from last year's model? I know it's all different, but what's the percentage?
Did I plant you in there? okay, well I suppose the question would be how much, do you think you would expect the bikes to go up in price? It's always a question on our lips whenever I go to a launch of a new bike or we go down to Oxford to get the national meetings in the UK. And on average, I think the prices have gone up by £200, £300 maximum, is that correct?
I think
Street Bob's gone up by £50.
Alright.
So you get a whole new bike, and it is a whole new bike. When Sean said earlier, the only things that are the same are part of the brakes even and the mirrors, yeah. Everything else is brand new. So we're all delighted with that, delighted as much as you guys will be. See, the test ride thing, if you're thinking about it like now, next month, next year, 3 years' time, we don't care. We still want you to come and test ride the bike. They're brand new. There's some people out there that are saying, oh no, I much prefer the traditional stuff. We want the more people riding the bikes, the better, because we're absolutely convinced that you'll love riding them. And we want to get the word out there, just how they feel. just in case you're absolutely desperate on a model year 17 bike, the bottom showrooms full of model 17 bikes, all that we've got left pretty much, and there will be deals on those as of this week, this coming week. So watch this space, be another communication out to you. We obviously want to move our stock on and make space for all the new stuff, so you can imagine what we'll be doing there. So, okay, any more questions? No, I'm sure you all want to get forward and get your hands on these bikes and have a proper look. There's a breakout up at the back, because I know there's a man here that'll be desperate to see a breakout. I've got another one outside. There's a Softail Lowrider somewhere else in the room to let you. Unfortunately, we don't have a deluxe, so I haven't managed to get one here on time. Because I know somebody else had asked me that question. So, thank you very much. Thanks a lot.